Hi, my name is Ndidi Obioha. 10 years ago, I was in the banking industry, but today I run a very successful event management company known as Enthys Event Consulting Company. People often ask me how I make it seem so easy, effortless, and flawlessly put together. I'm talking about the events that I do. But the truth is, it is not. It comes with a lot of pressure, tension, madness.
It is about the success of the event.
But I've got the best team on ground and I was built for this. It's a very demanding career for a wife and a mother of three. But in all of this, I love what I do. Welcome to my world, our world. We are the Event Bros. One of the things I enjoy most of all about being an event consultant is that it affords me the opportunity to travel around, locally and internationally. This time around, we were given the opportunity to put together a very memorable event for one of our clients. This event was done in Ohafia, Abia State. It was an amazing experience. As usual, we get to learn a lot, see a lot, and experience a lot. All of this makes it worth being an event consultant. Stay tuned. I hope you find this episode informative and, as usual, entertaining. Enjoy. There's a bit of drama, but hey, it comes with the terrain. Enjoy. You got the Airpeace flight, right?
Yes.
Okay, have you booked my flight?
I'm done with your booking.
You're done, okay.
Yes.
Airpeace. Okay, it has to be Airpeace. So I'm coming in with the, what time? 2:30
flight? 2:35
Thursday. 2:35, and we have the entire crew going.
Yes.
The ones coming by bus, have we sorted that out?
Alex is making arrangements for the bus.
Okay.
So the other things, the ushers are also going to come by.
They're also coming with him. Okay, and the roller banners, all the printed
everything
materials.
Is, Alex is in charge of everything.
Okay. So, I need a checklist before you catch your flight.
In the maker for me.
In Enugu. Okay.
Hi, in the maker.
What time is...
Okay. You've seen the place.
Put it on speaker. I need to speak to
you. Okay, hold on. The thing is...
Hello, Nnamaka.
Good afternoon.
Hi, Nnamaka, afternoon. Okay, so have you gone to look at the venue?
Yeah, I'm at the church.
You're at the church, okay. The venue, the reception is in that
field.
Huge compound, that huge field.
Just by the church.
Just by the church.
Okay.
Yes, that's where we're.
The church.
Yes. Okay. And I want each of the vendors to have 4 7 points.
Okay,
so please tell your boss, I want every vendor to have 4 7 points.
Okay.
Please send me pictures of the crockeries you're going to use. And then pictures of the crockeries you're going to use. Pictures.
The network, I can hear you very well.
Okay, but I can hear you clearly. Can you hear me now?
Sorry.
My name is Ndidi Obioha, Mrs. I run Enthys Events Limited and also Enthys Fashion Clinic, and then what we do as well, event consultants. And what we do at Enthys is where we conceptualize, we define, we plan, we package, manage and coordinate, and at the end of the day, execute and implement the event briefs that we've been given. So in doing all of this, what we do is we try to bring together very professional vendors to help us execute and implement the events that we do. So we are what we call the event consultant. We're an event consulting company. That is what we do at Enthys Events. You guys are coming, you know how we do it now.
Yeah, I was asking, every caterer will come with all these things?
Yes, every single caterer. Yes.
People don't mix up. How are we going to recover our items?
That's your bait. That's your bait. Every caterer will have their own service area, their sections that they're catering to.
Okay,
so,
every caterer will have their own section.
Yes, so it's not mixed catering. No. So you will get it. He couldn't make it yesterday, but he's coming in with a 2:30 flight, so he'll be there. But you can't wait. That's fair enough. We're making all the arrangements for all the vendors where you're going to cook and keep your stuff. All right. Tell her I'll talk to her later today. Okay.
All right.
But
all
please
right.
send me okay, the pictures that I want. Thank you, Nemeka. Thank you.
When I
yes, please. Thank you. Okay, so that's one of the vendors that we're using. One of the food vendors. We're getting this particular food vendor from the East, from Enugu. We've worked with them a couple of times, and they are very professional. So for me, I'm very pleased to be working with them again. And I always say, everybody can cook, but it's about the service delivery, and that they have proven themselves to be able to do very well. So we're using them. They'll be catering for at least 1,000 people at this event. I've got three catering vendors that will be taking care of the food aspect of the event. I've got two from Lagos and then one from Enugu. One of them is Golden Toast. That's the person I just spoke to, the representative from that company. She has just left now to catch his flight. She is the GM project manager for the company. So he's going to catch his flight to head out to Ohafia. Like I said, the 10 vendors are going to start setting up tonight. So he has to be on ground to show them where to set up the tent and make sure that everything goes on as flawless as possible. Now we would have to, I have some vendors waiting to meet with me. The media production people, and then I think the tent, one of the tent guys, to really let me know what's going on with their people on ground to give me proper reports. I've got a few other vendors here, the ones working with me for the Ohafia event. That is big. I mean, like I said, 4,000 guest size. God help me. But anyway, we're trying to make sure that we leave no stone unturned and all of that, and we dot all our I's and cross all our T's. Okay, so I've got David from Stretch Media. Now, Stretch Media is going to be taking... What are you doing for us for Ohafia?
We are supplying 4 LED screens.
Okay.
And we're doing the official videography.
Videography and production for the event and all that. So that's the whole live feed and recording.
Yes.
When are you setting out?
Actually, we're moving the equipment from here to Ohafia on Thursday with the crew members.
Thursday, so you'd arrive on Friday.
Yes,
and that
Friday morning we'll be there.
If you can leave, I'd like for you to come and set up here Friday.
Yes, by Friday morning, the equipment will be there.
Okay. I want a flawless setup, but time is of the essence, because we're all dependent on how soon you finish. Sooner, the moment you finish, the rest of the vendors can start their own job. So I need you to be on top of the game with your people over there to ensure. Are you going to be there? You're leaving tomorrow. Fantastic. Okay, good. So, Devo, fantastic. We're good. I'll see you guys in Ohafia by Thursday. All right. Regards to Mr. Tanner, your boss. All right, then. Take care.
To the prince original. Pull up, say. Pull up, say. Caesar be the man where you learn.
pull up, say, pull up, say, catch up in the man where you love. Pull up, say, pull up, say, Dre beats on this one, it's a new one. Yeah, say, doggy, doggy, da, 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 da. Tell me what I want when I step in out your town.
Finally made it to Ohafia. Oh, thank God. The flight was smooth. The driver was waiting for us. Yeah, he had been, I think he had been there for like maybe like 2 hours. But anyway, he was there. And I remember asking the driver how long it would take us to get to Ohafia. And he boldly said to me, "Oh, madam, 2 hours. And my staff, who had been before, had said to me that it took him about 3 or 4 hours. And at this point, I was dreading the journey. On our way to Ohafia, I remember my GM calling me and saying to me, "Ma, the chairs are here, the banquet chairs are here, but the plastic chairs are not here. And the banquet chairs still haven't been moved out of the truck to the venue to where they needed them to be placed." And boy, did I lose it. At that point, I called the vendor. Unfortunately for a job as planners, a lot of, especially as the event consultant, you do rely on vendors. Yeah, there are mishaps, the things that can happen along the way and all of that, which you make allowance for. But I didn't see this coming. I was so sure that the plastic chairs and the banquet chairs, you know, were about 3,500 or 4,000, you know, would have gotten there at the time I was arriving.
But please, I need things to be sorted out. But things I cannot do tomorrow morning. It will not work. You are going to totally mess up my whole arrangements with all my other vendors. You're not the only vendor on ground now. The decorator has more work to do than you can imagine. He has more work to do than you can imagine. So please call whoever you're getting those chairs from in the east to deliver those chairs this night. No, seriously, don't tell me no problem and then you don't. It would not be funny. I don't want this. I don't. I'm being very honest with you. I don't want this at all. Because I'm very surprised that I'm getting all this from you. And this is what I told you that I did not want to happen. And you gave me your words, you gave me your assurance, and I took a chance on you.
So having been told by my vendor that the chairs wouldn't arrive until the following morning, which was Friday morning, I needed to think of a plan B. And that's what makes us different. That's what makes us the professional event planners. We are able to make a contingency plans for challenges like this. So what we now decided to do was get the locals involved, and that's a way of creating job opportunities also when we do the destination events. So what we did was we got the locals involved. Instead of having 15 staff from the decorators that would have worn the chair covers on all chairs, if the chairs had arrived on Wednesday, 15 of his staff would have been enough, sufficient to wear the chair covers. But knowing that the chairs were to be delivered on Friday morning for an event on Saturday, and we needed to decorate almost 4,000 chairs, we needed to make that decision. So we got the locals involved. We got about 30 locals to add on to the 15 that the decorator had brought, or 20. And by morning, when the chairs arrived, in less than 5 hours, all the chairs had the chair covers on them. So hey, that was good for us. So that aspect was sorted. So having seen the venue and making sure that everything was going on okay, I proceeded to go see my client that they know I had arrived and were not too sure if I would make the flight. But hey, I also do keep to my word. So on getting to the client's house, we were warmly received. Food, all of that prepared for us. Chatted with my client, was very happy to see that. And I must say, I wish I would have more clients like Mr. and Mrs. Uzokalo. They were amazing, they were warm. And the good thing was that they believed in what we're going to deliver. They totally trusted us with their event and let us do our job. So it was the hospitality from my client and his wife was just absolutely fantastic. And it did make me feel more at home being there. The next day, that was Friday. Okay, I remember we had to set out early. I called Shay, my ever reliable GM. It was 5:30, he was already at the venue. And this is us expecting the chairs that my vendor had promised I would be there first thing in the morning. On getting to the venue, I got there at about 8 o'clock. My client insisted that I had breakfast before leaving. Very sweet of them. Anyway, so we get there and then we start putting calls out to the vendor who was trying to organize the chairs to be delivered to us at the venue. While waiting for that, we were ensuring that every other thing was happening. The picket fences were being put up, which was to create like some barricade around the field and all that, and added to the ambience. It was very pretty, and that was my client's idea. Fantastic. So anyway, so we now start, you know, waiting for the chairs. It took quite a while though for the chairs to arrive, but while we were waiting, what I found very interesting was that I actually had the locals come to me to say to me, "Madam, we want to work. What can we do? How can we be of help?" Now, I have been to different parts of Nigeria to do events, which indirectly we do call destination events, where you do it outside your zone. And Ohafia is the one place that I have seen the locals being willing to want to work and earn from the job that you've given them. Most places we go to, you find them come and say, auntie, uncle, anything for us, anything for the boys. Not that they're willing to work, but they want you to give them something just to go. But the Ohafia man obviously is a very hard man. He would rather work and earn from that job that he's done than to be given handouts. So for me, I that was very laudable, and I did like that. And of course, their services were very much welcome. Let me tell that the Ohafia people or man is not a lazy person. They want to work. And don't get me wrong, definitely they're going to earn something from what they're doing. But we have been to other destinations where we actually have to beg for the locals to come out and, you know, assist where we need help. But these people have been on us since we got here yesterday, wanting to know where they can come in, what they can do. In fact, they were here as early as 7 this morning, right? Wanting to be part of this. They were here last night. So it's very impressive. It is very impressive. When the chairs arrived, they set to work, and to my greatest surprise and joy, in less than 5 hours, the chairs were all covered. That was fantastic. Then the other vendors start to arrive. I remember my ever faithful security company that I like to use when I do my destination events. It's called the Spider Security Company. Spider arrives with his crew, and the villagers all start because they see the big guys all working. And it was hilarious. But I mean, Spider I find to be very professional. Once would get to the venue on time, get his brief, do what we call a recce of the venue to understand that space that they're working with.
Because they're starting with church. So I want church secure, I want here secure. So,
okay. That certain barriers there.
Yes. Okay. It's part of ambience.
To work tomorrow? To...
Come back at night, I'll talk. Okay. Hmm? Okay. Come back at night, but then we'll set up more. We'll have a meeting at night.
Okay,
right?
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
All right. I remember, we had to have our vendors meeting. Now, this is also the fact that a lot of our vendors had to come from outside the state. We actually did take quite a number of vendors from Lagos. So everybody had to arrive that day and they had to be settled. The caterers arrived that day. The finger food people arrived that day. The drinks company we got from Enugu and all that. And in doing all this, you also have to consider the client's budget and see how much you can actually patronize from people within the area. So it was in Ohafia. Ohafia is in Abia State. So we were able to get some vendors also from Enugu, from Owerri, just to help bring down the cost. And before this, we had made our inquiries to make sure and let them know what kind of standard we expect them to deliver in their service delivery. And a lot of them actually did very well. I was very impressed. Is to use the ethnic fabric. It's in the village, okay? So I always believe that when you're doing something in the village and all of that, you add some ethnic or traditional touch to it, which is what I like that we've done here. I like the ethnic fabric on this side. I like it on the stage. So we can easily wrap this up to also complement what we've done on stage. So that, and I like the lanterns. The lanterns depict the whole ethnic thing too. So that works for me. So let's wrap this up, okay, with the same ethnic fabric. And then we're good. I still want us to keep it simple, okay? And then we're still able to achieve what we want to achieve. So that those are my corrections that I would like, you to note, and let's get that done. Okay. But other than that, I'm happy, I'm glad, and it's looking like we'll be done in another 3 hours.
Yes,
hopefully. We don't want to sleep here. The essence for the vendors meeting is to ensure that you're on the same page with all your vendors and let them know, again, reiterated, what you're expecting from them and all that. And that did go well. As at the time we were to do the vendors meeting, all the vendors were on ground and that was fantastic. We always would call a vendors meeting for every event that we're doing. One of the reasons, objectives for calling this meeting is to make sure that we're all on the same page and we all understand what our deliverables are. Now what I want is the success of what you're doing would be measured as to how many minutes it takes to serve everybody around your own area. Now I insist, you all already know your points. I would want food in 30 minutes. I want everybody to have eaten. Because you see, the longer you take, the more anxious the guests get. And I do not want a situation where your waiters are skipping tables or skipping people on a table. You start a table, you finish that table. You go on to the next one, you finish. You make sure you finish. If somebody has asked for something different from what you have on your tray, you tell the guest that you'll be back. And that waiter must come back and finish up that table. I do not want a situation where I hear that, oh, the caterers were skipping tables. I don't want that at all. Stay tuned to Sins for my next episode.
Here.
Yeah, exactly.
And the success of the event is all that I'm after. I don't care what I don't have time for anybody's personal whatever. That's all I'm after.
Slick City Empire.